Hey, Rob here from P6 Media. We're gonna do a bit of a shootout here today. And today we have the Spark 40, the Spark Mini, and the new Spark Go. This is the newest one from Positive Grid's offering. And each system is hooked up to a microphone. We've got 57s hooked up about 4 inches-ish apart from the microphones, and we're going to do a shootout test for each one. Each of these systems has the same guitar preset on. It's pretty much just a clean kind of Fender output thing, and the reason for that is that you're going to get to hear and feel the sound of each one. After we do a sound test for each one, we're going to do a phone test. You can kind of see that little hookup doohickey thing up front. And I'm gonna throw my phone onto that and we'll do a sound test from that for a real world recording. But so the transmitter or the receiver for the transmitter of this guitar is loaded into the Spark 40 right now. You can hear it. And yeah, I'll just play some chords. I'll play just a few licks and you'll get the sense of what it sounds like when it's mic'd up. So that's the Spark 40. We're gonna throw it into the Spark Mini. Same preset. I have it cranked at top right now. Whereas the 40, I had it at 40% maybe? Yeah, 40%. So this is the Mini right now. So we got a Strat in fourth position here. That's the sound that's coming through. So that was the Spark Mini. And of course, everyone wants to know what's going on with the Go. So the Spark Go, this is it. Same preset as these two here. I loaded them into each one. And this is all three units have been upgraded to the latest firmware, so the sound is the sound. I just got this like 2 days ago, so I'm not sure if the speaker's been broken in, but it's what it is. So here we go. So something important to note is that when I put this out to the internet, none of the levels on these things are going to be normalized in respect to each other. They're all going to be normalized, but just in relative loudness to each other. So again, each of these are about 4 to 5 inches apart from the front of the speaker. The loudness on this is at max, the loudness on this is at max, and the loudness on this is at 40. So you'll get a sense of what it is what it feels like, what it sounds like, that kind of thing. Okay, so that is the guitar portion of that. What I want to do right now, and I'm going to go grab my phone to do this thing, so give me a second. All right, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to play some music through each of these guys here. Let me turn this down. We're going to play music through the 40. We're going to play music through the B or the Mini. I have Spark B, I have Spark A. And this guy's my newest guy in the studio. So what I'm going to do right now is going to pop music through it so you hear what music sounds like through the Bluetooth system. And hopefully this works. I have no idea if it'll work or not. I'm going to put the music on the 40 at half. I'm going to put the music on the Mini at 3/4. And the music on the Go is going to be at cranked. And I'm going to play on right now, to be honest. I have no idea where that's playing right now. Hold on. Okay, so now I got this figured out. That was a bit of a disaster, but okay. So this is music playing through the Spark 40 at, where are we at here? It's at half volume. So 50% volume. This is the music recorded through the microphone at half volume. I'm going through a drought. You don't even have to do too much. You can turn me on with just a touch. Got that, you feel that, you hear that. Okay, so we're gonna go to the Spark Mini. Let me turn off the 40. Let's go to the Mini. Okay, so this is gonna be the sound coming through the Spark Mini recorded on the 57. You're hearing it in kind of real world, and then they say in the room, but yeah. Let's hear how it sounds. I can see clearly when you're gone. All I said, I'm blinded by the lies. No, I can't sleep until I feel your touch. I said. Okay, so you got a sense of like how it gets tone shaped. Let me see if I can get it playing over the Go. This is a weird setup because it allows you to kind of connect to, I'll turn off both these guys. Let's see if I can connect to the Go and we'll hear how that sounds. Are you on, Mr. Go? Yeah, you're on. Okay. Spark Go audio. All right. We're connected. So this is how it sounds over the Go. And the reason I'm doing this is so that you'll hear it tone shaped. Basically any kind of sound that comes through these speakers, you'll get a sense of like how it will affect everything else. You heard it with the guitar and now you're hearing it.
Sunlight up the sky, so I hit the road in overdrive, baby. Oh, see.
Oh, baby, you gotta turn on. So the funny thing about the Spark 40 is I have that weird battery pack kind of mod going. All right, there we go. And when you turn it on and off, the battery pack here, you gotta switch it to the right voltage. Half volume. That's half volume on the 40. It's super loud. And the mini. Take that off. Look, hold on. Let's go to the go first. Again, the go. Amazing, right? For this little kind of speaker. Okay, so a lot of people online are talking about this being very quiet, and it kind of is compared to the Spark Mini. Spark Mini I took with me. Let me just pop this over here. The Spark Mini I took with me on when I was traveling last year for 3 months. I put it in my backpack. It was amazing. It acted as a preamp. It did all kinds of amazing stuff. And the best thing about it is that it was loud enough. It was loud enough for street jams. It was loud enough for just hanging out with friends. It was loud enough for beach parties, all kinds of stuff. It was great. This thing will not be loud enough for that. It'll be loud enough for you hanging out and some guy lightly strumming on his acoustic guitar. It'll be loud enough for that, but it also acts as a preamp. This is the most hidden beauty of this thing and all Spark products, is that you can do the line out. When you do the line out, you set it to mono. When you set it to mono, you can go into a PA system and have it act as a preamp. And the preamp functions, this little thing as a preamp is absolutely amazing. Considering you can put this in your pocket, it's phenomenal. But if you want to do some street jams, this is your person. This is your guy. You can do street jams with this too, but then you also have to do that. You gotta get that big battery pack, you gotta like jerry rig it, you gotta turn it on and off and put it this right voltage, all kinds of nonsense. If the 40 had a battery pack attached to it natively, this would have been the ultimate busking experience. But it doesn't have one, so the best thing to do with this guy is get a battery pack if you want to play it out and you want to busk with it. If you want to do microphone on top of the busking, I haven't tried this yet, but you can get like a preamp, like those little red rocket type, I can't remember what they're called, but red rocket type preamp things that go in line. You put the battery in them, throw it into the line in over here, and you can actually get some microphone output on this as well. And this thing, I actually played it next to a Fishman busking acoustic amp, and it actually blew it away. Cleanliness and loudness on every level. So you can actually use these guys as a busking amplifiers if you want to. These guys are perfect, perfect travel amps. I love them to death. Love them to death. I had so much fun with my Spark. I actually have two of these. This is my studio one, and then I have a different one with the beige grill that I take with me traveling, and it was fantastic. And this little guy I just got a couple days ago. I can't wait to take this with me literally everywhere. I popped this into my PA system in the studio, and it sounded just as good as this guy and this guy. So as a preamp to pop into a PA system, you take like an eighth inch into like a double mono output, or even an eighth inch into a single mono output or a single quarter inch output. You do that with this, and you can basically take this anywhere and play on any stage. It sounds absolutely fantastic. As a traveling companion amp, yeah, man, you get what you pay for here. And I've had other Bluetooth speakers this size that were absolutely fantastic. And actually, this one sounds better for what you get. So even as a basically just a Bluetooth speaker, this one sounds absolutely amazing. I know I said I would do the phone recording thing, but you know what? I'm not going to do that. If you want to hear the phone recording comparison type thing, you can go to the Spark Amp Owners Facebook group, and I actually did a comparison between these two there with guitar and with music, and you can look at those videos there. The only reason I'm doing this video is because the people there said, do a YouTube video comparing all three. I have five of these things. So I have one of these, I have two of these, and I have two of these. And I figured if anyone's going to be able to do it, it's the guy with 12 cameras, which I have in the studio, all the beautiful lighting, and five of these amps. So I hope you enjoyed what you heard tonight and all the information I gave you and all that kind of stuff. And if you like it, maybe we'll do more of these things. I don't know. I'm Rob. I'm from P6 Gear. P6 Gear? Is that what we're calling this channel? P6 Gear. Maybe we're going to call it Super Special Gear. I don't know. You're hearing a little bit of feedback there because I have the monitors on. But I appreciate you watching this, and we'll go to the next one maybe sometime soon. I got lots of gear in here I want to review. I don't know, maybe you guys want to see it as well. I don't know. We'll figure it out.